हेलो हाय गाइस, इन द लास्ट वी हैव कंटिन्यूड अप टू द स्टार्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर्स केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन. नाउ फर्दर वी विल कंटिन्यू द केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन दैट व्हिच टाइप ऑफ चेंजिंग द टॉपिक दैट वाज यस्टरडे दैट इज लेफ्ट अनकम्प्लीटेड दैट इज द रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ मेटल विद एन एसिड. एज यू नो दैट when the metal react with the acid it will produce the salt of a metal along with the hydrogen gas. As a hydrogen is it is in the gas form, so it will be liberated out of the solution or out of the mixture, and but the salt that is formed due to the reactivity of a metal along with the acid it will precipitate down into the solution or it will dissolve in the solution. So it will cause the problem, a health related problem, if we consume anything. Hence there is a if the question come in exam and it is asking to you that why we should not put any acidic or sour substance into a metal container, the reason behind that it form the salt, the salt of the metal, if we consume it may create the harmful effect into our body. Hence we do not consume these type of salts. So there is the first in the first point the explanation of that answer is given here. You may continue the two points, the last one points of our last topic and the first and second first point of the this topic. These two points are the exact answer of the question if it will come into the exam and it is asking to you why we should not put the sour or acidic substance into the metal. So the reason is so simple, because it produces salt, and that salt if we consume, the amount of the metal will be increased into our body, and that goes that will put into us in a danger, or it will cause the danger effect to us. Now further we will continue it that how we know that the hydrogen gas is produced. Yes, the gas doesn't have any type of a color, any type of a shape that we can see it or we can watch it into with our naked eyes. So there are some experiment which give us a proof that the hydrogen gas is produced or another gas is produced. For that purpose we have an experiment. As you know that hydrogen and oxygen are flammable gas, that means they help the flammable procedure, and there is a property of a hydrogen gas that it is along with the flammable gas it will burn with the pop-up sound. So the pop-up sound, just like a crackers, whenever we blast the crackers the sound comes, same type of a sound come with the burning of a hydrogen gas. So there is an experiment. In this experiment what we are doing, we have took the test tube. In this test tube we have put the some dilute sulfuric acid and put some small pieces of zinc that we known as that we called here the zinc granules into the dilute sulfuric acid. As the acid react with the metal it will produce the hydrogen gas. We have covered the top most portion of the test tube and connected with the pipe that is known as by the delivery tube, and that pipe opened into the solution. That is a solution of a soap solution. Why? Because that type of a solution, it is a liquid in nature. As you know that whenever we have flow some air into a liquid, the bubbles will produce. So same type of a concept we want to use it here, because if we perform the reaction or the experiment that we want to perform, the pop-up for the pop-up sound, if we will perform above the test tube it will produce the pop-up sound exactly, but it may cause the some type of a injury to us. Hence we do not want to perform our experiment above the test tube, but we want to perform our experiment just beside the test tube. So as the hydrogen gas passes through the solution of the soap solution, that the bubbles of hydrogen gas will produce, and these bubbles of hydrogen gas as escape from that port, and we have put a candle, and that is a burning candle. When the flame of the candle will come in the contact of the bubbles, the bubble will produce a cracking sound or a pop-up sound that will give us a proof that this type of the gas produced in this experiment, it is a hydrogen gas. Because the pop-up sound on the flammable, it is the experiment, that experiment gives the proof or the it gives the way that the gas they produce, it is a hydrogen gas. Now further we will continue. What is the chemical equation? The representation of the chemical reaction into a symbol form generally known as by the chemical equation. Basically the reaction that are occur in our world, that in our word, in our universe, if we want to represent them into a words, then it is a complicated, because sometimes the reaction will continue, one reaction's product will participate into the another reactions, and another reaction product will participate into the third one reaction, so on the reaction will continue. So simply I mean to say that when there are the more reactions, they are in the continue, to represent them into word, it is a difficult procedure. Just like I want to give an example, if I have said that one molecule of hydrogen gas react with the one atom of oxygen and it will produce the water. So that type of a theory that I have said, it, if I want to represent it, then the representation, it is too easy to represent that one. So how it will produce the water? So what I have said and what I have write. So here there is a difference between the representation and there is a difference between the saying to something. So if we want to explain into word, it will be a big procedure. It will consume more area. But right now we have represent them more simply, that one molecule of hydrogen gas react with one atom of oxygen and will produce the one compound of a water. So it is the way the representation of any chemical reaction into a symbol forms or molecular forms, it is known as by the chemical equation. So there are some rules that we will learn at here. Those substances which are taking part in a reactions, those substances which are responsible to start a reaction, they are generally known as by the reactant. And those substances, they are formed due to the reactivity of a reactant, are known as by the product. Reactant are generally written on the left hand side, whereas product are written on the right hand side. If there are two or more than two reactant or product, then we will use the plus sign between them. If there are the three, then we will use the further plus sign between them. There is an arrow that is started from reactant and will end to the product in general way, but it is not necessary. The arrow generally represent the direction of a reaction, the in which way the reaction is going. Its tail is toward the reactant and its head toward the product. So it represents the reaction is going toward the product, or whenever the reaction is going toward the product, it is generally known as by the forward reaction. If further product is starting to convert itself into a reactant, means it is going to the backward direction, hence then it will known as by the backward direction. So there are the two direction in the reaction. One is a forward direction, and another is backward direction. When the reactant converted into the product, it is generally known as a forward direction. And when the product again converted into the reactant, then it is known as by the backward direction. So in this way, the reaction will continue. And another thing is what? Everything is completed. And I have given one example in the last, that one when the magnesium react with the oxygen, it will form the magnesium oxide. So the magnesium and oxygen, they are the initial substance and they are known as by the reactant, and the magnesium oxide form, that is known as by the product. So in this way, these are the some properties of writing the chemical equation. We will further learn about it into the detail in our next classes. For that time, for now, goodbye.